Hopefully this thing isn't moody and we'll staple. Stapler did all right. Got a little moody there at the end. Can't take it anymore. I'm gonna have to do some maintenance. Pass load. Dang good tool. Each box, staples. Probably 2,500 staples per box. I've had this gun for, I don't know, 6 years. Hold on, I have to turn off my compressor. Shut up! Oh, a box, a staples per house? 100, 200, 300,000 staples, I don't know. So it has a right to be cranky. But we're gonna drop some oil in it. I think we're supposed to always put it in here. I'm on the fence about putting oil in the gun. I've had troubles with it. I seem to have more luck when I never oil my gun. Not to mention I'm not good at maintenance. Anywho, let's take the cap off. The Allen wrench. Which, yes, it does fit. It's actually tucked in the back of the nailer. This is about as far as I like my mechanical skills to go. Air tool lubricant, antifreeze. Who makes this? Coil House Pneumatics. Made in the USA. I'm gonna frame that bottle. Made, did you hear me? Made in the USA. Wow. Wish there was more of that. That's my little rant for the day. So, after you do this, piece of advice, make sure you put the cap on straight. After you got that figured out, don't let this get you anywhere in the face because it's a pile of oil coming out. Truth is also that my compressor behind me, it's a little old. I bought it in 1999 and it's been compressing it for me ever since. I don't know why it keeps going, but it does. It's a Coleman compressor. My buddy Mike, when I bought it, bugged me all the time because he asked if I got a tent with that there compressor. It's funny because he replaced his once. Ha, Mike. little noise here. We'll compress up.